Good morning. Welcome to another morning devotion here from Saron United Church of Christ. I'm excited that you made it to another week and that I did too. I'm excited that you chose to start the day by hearing a word from me. That is always a privilege and always an honor. What I thought I would read today is a little bit of a devotional that Richard Foster put together. I appreciate his sensibility, and he always helps me slow down and see things from a way I didn't. And so, as I moved through this book, looking for a piece to share here, my eye was caught by a certain word that I think maybe is a little bit more applicable in this season than it has been in others, and it's the word loneliness. I wonder if you have felt more lonely in the last 10 months than you did before or do normally. Most of us have, I believe. And so this prayer, this little thing that he wrote, this little reflection struck me. And so I offer this up to start your week, to start your day, to move through Advent here, the early part of Advent, which can be a lonely season. This by Richard Foster, titled Praying Through Loneliness. Today, O Lord, I feel the loneliness of anonymity. No one in this place knows me and no one cares. At least it seems that way. So I am left to my own thoughts. I am left to my own self. My loneliness, of course, is quite comfortable. It's not the loneliness of the truly abandoned, but it perhaps can help me enter more fully into their feelings of abandonment. O Lord, may my small experiences of loneliness teach me to have fellowship with all those who are marginalized. When I eat alone, help me pray for those who have nothing to eat. When I walk the streets alone, help me remember those who do not have the strength to walk. When I feel on the outside of every conversation, help me see the nameless people to whom no one pays attention. When I speak and am ignored, help me hear those whose voices fall on deaf ears. And whenever my circumstances are devoid of familiar voices, may I always be able to hear the voice of the true shepherd. Amen. My friends, I imagine you are living through a season that is devoid of familiar voices, and maybe in the holiday season we have just entered, that's becoming heavier and heavier. My prayer for you, my prayer for me, is that I may be able to hear much more clearly in this season the voice of my shepherd calling. Be blessed today.